evening, and thank you for coming to tonight's transition evening for parents. My name is Bradley Abrahams, I'm deputy head teacher in charge of all things pastoral in the school and overhead of the transition process, which of course this year has been rather tricky to say the least, but we really appreciate you coming. So without any further ado, before I hand over to Nellie's head teacher, two quick announcements. Firstly, there's no planned fire drill at this time of night, so if the fire alarm does go, please just stay seated and we'll give you further directions. And the second thing is that tonight's session is being filmed so that we can show it to parents who are unable to come this evening.
Welcome to Council King Solomon High School. I have to behave and I have to stand behind a lectern, and I'm really bad at doing that. The teacher in me wants me to move all over the place. So if I'm fidgeting, that's what I'm doing. Welcome to Canterbury King Solomon High School. As Mr. Abrahams said, my name is Hanel Rees. I'm the head teacher, and I've been the head teacher here now for 4 years. I've actually been at the school for over 20 years, and that's the first thing that I want to say to you, is that you're not just joining, your children are not just joining a school, but you're joining a community. It's not just me that's been here for a very long time. If you look at a lot of my leadership team, they have been members of the community, are members of the community, all have been at the school for a very long time. And many of our staff are returning students, which is one of the things that makes me really, really proud. We have ex-students at all levels, all the way through to one of our assistant head teachers who I taught, which makes me feel 105. But so, well done. I want to say also congratulations. We believe that Canterbury King Solomon High School is a very, very special community to be part of. It's the reason that we've all been here quite so long as we have. Additionally, though, I want to say thank you. More than ever before, we're really, really abundantly aware that there are so many different places that you could choose to send your children. So it's a real privilege that you've chosen Canterbury King Solomon High School, and I want to thank you for that. If anybody saw this BBC drama, you will remember, it was about 3 years ago, you'll remember that it features an angel and a devil, and they work together, very bizarrely, to bring up the Antichrist. The angel is of course tasked with ensuring that the child of the Antichrist turns to good. The devil obviously is tasked with ensuring that the child of the Antichrist turns to bad. And I think it raises some really fundamental questions about nature versus nurture. At King Solomon High School, we believe that students who are safe and happy are the students who make progress. We believe that nurture is stronger than nature. And one of the key things I want to say to you is that we're working in partnership with yourselves. By us working together with you, we can make sure that your child achieves their very best potential. What sort of school have you joined? What have your children joined? It is a school that values community. It's a school that values learning, and it's a school that values charity. At King Solomon, we believe that our motto can help our students get through their life. The first line of their motto, it's like our motto, says, "If I am not for myself, who will be for me?" And we think that's a very important place to start. We all have to advocate for ourselves. If your children don't learn to advocate for themselves, nobody's going to do it for them in the society in which they're going to join. So it's really important that they develop the skills and the confidence to be able to say, this is who I am, this is where I'm from, and this is how I'm going to make a positive change to the world. By following sensible behaviour guidelines, by participating properly in class, making sure they're learning and getting qualifications, they're looking after their future, and that's something that's very, very important. It's the first and most important. The second line of our motto says, but if I am only for myself, who am I? We all know one person can make a positive difference. But a whole community of people all working together can make a much stronger difference. One of the things I've been talking to our students about in assemblies is changing their shared tomorrows. And I make the point to them, they've got a lot more shared tomorrows, please God, than I have. And so it should be in their interests to work together as a community to improve the world in the way that they want to do it. And finally, our motto says, if not now, when? Anything that's worth doing is worth doing now. And so the other thing that I want to say to you is, encourage your students not to wait for opportunity to land on them, but get them to go out, get them to discover the different opportunities that we have. We have a myriad of different sports clubs, we have performing arts clubs, we have STEM clubs, we have all sorts of opportunities. At Glasgow King Solomon High School, we are devoted to your child's pathway. And that's quite difficult because, of course, every child has an individual pathway. It might feel like this is the journey, but actually, in 2028, this is where we want to see your students, your children. It seems like a long time away. It really isn't going to be that long before your children are sitting here. We believe in something called Hedera. One of our student leadership pathways is Hedera, and it means the path, your child's path. We have a myriad, as I said, of extracurricular opportunities. Things including student leadership and student observers. We're introducing a new Key Stage 3 scholarship program. So students in years 7, 8, and 9 who excel in a particular aspect of either performing arts, of STEM, so science, technology, engineering, and maths, or sport, will have the opportunity to push themselves to apply for and to become a scholar. It's really, really good to be able to have you here in person. It's been a little bit strange. This is the third one of these sessions we've done today. You'd think I'd have learned my lines by now, and I still haven't. But it's really, really good to have the opportunity to get you into school, to face-to-face, to say hello, so that when your children start in September, it isn't the first time you've stepped foot in the place. Thank you for coming, and I shall now hand over to Ms. Darren House.
Next up, I'm going to introduce Ms. Deanne Marwell. Ms. Marwell is in charge of all things teaching and learning. So you're going to get a lot of information about the relevant apps that you'll need to download, how assessment works, the school day, timetables. There's a lot to take in, but please be assured you will be receiving all your email, and a lot of it is in your packs already. But we think it will be really useful to have it spoken through so you really get an idea of what to expect when your child starts with us in September. So Ms. Marwell, over to you.
With a year group of 180. Please don't be alarmed. Instead, we ask that you ask some growth mindset questions of your child. Where are the gaps in your learning? What do you need to focus on in order to improve? And then trust the right process, that the right students will be moved up as and when. It is fluid, but it's really important you understand that students can be moved up and down, but you will be informed in writing. It's not something that happens every day or every week. It happens a couple of points a year, and we do keep you informed. I wanted to also talk to you about English and maths separately. We understand that because students have missed out on quite a lot of learning in year 5 and year 6 over the last 2 years, they're coming with some gaps. And they'll all have different gaps depending on their primary school, depending on the diet of online learning that they were given. So we're going to be doing a few things initially to try and work out where the gaps are. All the students will do an accelerated reading test, and that gives us an idea of their current reading age. They'll also do a CATS test because they're not doing Key Stage 2 SATs this year. They'll do a short numeracy task in their maths lesson and a short writing task in their English lesson. We'll triangulate all that information together and work out which students are missing key parts of the numeracy and literacy curriculum. If that applies to your child, we will inform you in writing, but more importantly, let you know how we're going to support them. So we've got a range of literacy programs and catch-up things planned, and if that applies to your child, you will be informed. I also wanted to talk to you a little bit about homework. So homework is published on an app called Show My Homework. It's part of the Satchel applications. So the students need to download this on either a tablet or a mobile phone. It's free, and they'll be given a code to plug in. So all their homework will be on a homework calendar for them. The beauty of Show My Homework is that you also get a parent login. So they'll be coming home in those first few weeks of term with a login that they should be giving you. We strongly recommend that you put the same application on your phone and tablet, especially in those first few early months, so you can help support them, remind them, get them into good homework habits. The way that we assess students is very different, again, to primary school. So students will do a series of topics or units depending on the subject. So in English, as an example, they might do poetry, then Romeo and Juliet, then detective writing. They're assessed throughout, but at the end of each unit or module, we do a common assessment, and that is plugged into our centralised mark book. Elements of that are reported to you and shared with the students. Now we have a video that could be a presentation on its own for how we assess students in year 7 and 8. You'll have the QR code and the YouTube link. I strongly recommend that you take some time to watch the video and understand how we assess and what we report to you and when. We also show this video to students in their first few months as well, so they understand the different colours they're being awarded and what it reflects. Another application we ask that you download to your phone or tablet is the Parents Sims app. We use Sims as our data. It's where we hold everything. So you will be able to download the parent app and see your child's timetable, their attendance data, and that's where we publish school reports. So you'll get 3 school reports a year, and those dates are on our calendar. Each time we publish a report, we also send you an email just to let you know this term's report is live, but you'll find it on the Sims app. You go into the app, there'll be a photograph of your child, you click on it, and then you'll be able to their school reports, and they're saved there for the duration of their time at our school, so you'll be able to look back and reflect on their progress over time. If you have more than one child at the school, you don't get a new login. The second child is added to your first child, so you'll notice that your second child's photo will also appear, and you'll be able to click on that in the same way. I mentioned previously that all the students do a reading test, and we use the Accelerated Reader platform. So the students will start off and they'll do their test, and as I said, it generates a reading age. We don't share a child's reading age with them. Instead, we share with them their reading range. So all the books in our library have a sticker on them, levelled 1 to 9. So we will say to a student, right, your reading range this term is 3 to 5, as an example. And we will encourage them through their library lesson, but also in their extra time, to read as many books as they can from their reading range. Each time they read a book, they do a short 10-question quiz on that book that tests how well they've been able to engage with the story, the characters and themes. And then the next term, we retest them and we have a look to see if their reading age has improved or not. And that's part of the way that we'll be tracking the progress of your students. What's really good about Accelerated Reader is there's a platform for you to use at home called Home Connect. So once the students have their first library lesson, they'll be coming home with a letter for you, and that gives you instructions to set up your account and sign on at home. So you'll be able to see your child's reading range, but you'll also be able to see their virtual bookshelf with everything they've read and how they've scored on their quizzes. So you'll be able to champion them at home, motivate them to do some extra reading as well. Here at KS, we are a Microsoft school, and that means that each student will get a Microsoft 365 login. That will be their school login, but also their login for 365. Because of that, through our school subscription, they will get access to the whole Microsoft package for free. So if they download Word, for example, on their phone or a tablet, with their school password, they'll be able to get access to the full complement of the Word app. Same for PowerPoint, OneNote, Teams, etc. If you've ever bought the Microsoft package for a home computer, you'll know it's about £100. But with their school sign-in, they'll be able to install that on up to 5 devices at home. So they can do one at parents' house, one at grandparents' house, one at auntie's house, wherever they're going to be working. So you can upload that on a laptop, a desktop, or any tablet that has Microsoft. All you do is ask them to log on, Google, log in to Microsoft 365, get them to log in, and on the right-hand side, there'll be a button that says Install Now. And then once they've installed it, they'll have the full complement of Word, PowerPoint, and Teams installed on your home computers. And we do recommend that you sit with them and that you do that with them. My last slide is a just-in-case slide. So at the moment, we're very hopeful that government legislation will change and that students won't be sent home to isolate from September onwards. But we need to plan a just-in-case. So I want to let you know what will happen if, as things stand, students are sent home to isolate. They follow their normal timetable, and they will be able to dial in to the lesson that's going on in the classroom from home through Microsoft Teams. So through their Teams calendar, they'll see all the lessons that they have timetabled that day, and they press join now one at a time. And the teacher will include them in the learning as best they can. Bear with them, we're all learning as we go, but your students won't miss out if they are asked to isolate. If it's a practical lesson, for example, if it's design technology, there's no way the student can do that at home. So more practical subjects, Microsoft Teams. As a just-in case, all our Year 7s upon arrival will be taken to some computer rooms and taught how to use Microsoft Teams, how to use the calendar, and how they can access their learning at home. It can be done on a phone, a tablet, a laptop, or a desktop. So if they don't have a computer at home, they'll still be able to access the learning. Thank you very much.
So as a school, our ethos drives everything that we do: learning, charity, and community. And community, as you've heard earlier, really is at the heart of everything. So I'm delighted to welcome up Miss Melanie Schutz, who is the assistant head teacher in charge of ethos and making that happen on a day-to-day basis. Thank you. Contained within something special just for Year 7. If they feel they need
have a buddy system, whereby a member of Year 12 will look out for and look after a Year 7 student and listen to what they have to say. If you look in the block in the middle, you can see our school motto, that again, Miss Rees articulated, is about I, we, and now. We develop the I, we understand the we, and the opportunities present themselves now. And it's no coincidence that I've written the fourth word there, future, the Hebrew word atid, and I've written gold, because our school has so many golden opportunities for our students to feel connected to the Kehillah, that when they come out of our school, they can go forward with confidence as informed young people who know that they can give and take in equal measure. So we look forward to welcoming your children in Year 7, and we hope they'll really enjoy being part of our special year. Thank you very much.
Okay, so now I would like to invite Tilly and Harris up. So these are two of our current Year 7 students. So this time last year, they were very nervous. They didn't have a full transition program, but they'd like to tell you about how their first year presented itself and their experience here at Canterbury.
Teachers and staff will refuse to rest until they know that your child has been pushed to do the best they can and will always provide support throughout. I can proudly say that this school has a community like no other, and no matter what, your child can never be alone. Many other Year 12 students and I are part of a buddy scheme in which we become someone to relate to for your student if they are struggling through their transition. As well as this, King Solomon offers a range of clubs for whatever your child is passionate for, whether it be sport, art, or even new clubs such as Eco Club and Detective Club, recent developments by our new prefect team. KKS is proving year after year that its students are achieving above the national average, and this is once again thanks to our magnificent staff around the school. Being in Year 12, I'm currently doing my A-levels, and the support I received from my subject and my application to university has been simply incredible. I could never ask for a better school and group of people to have spent my life at school with. King Solomon's diverse mix of cultures has allowed me to meet people of all different backgrounds, but most importantly, it has taught me how to interact and prepared me for later life in the best way possible.
When I was applying for this position, during my interview I was asked why I wanted this role. Why did I want to represent County King Solomon? For me the answer is simple, community. We are one big community that take care and look after each other, and I wanted to give back to the school that has moulded me into the person I am today. County King Solomon has opened my eyes to a diverse range of cultures other than my own, and taught me the importance of community through Jewish teachings and values. One thing that I love about County King Solomon are the core pillars in which our life revolves around, which originates from an important teaching from Ethics of the Fathers. The world stands on three things: learning, serving the community, and acts of kindness. I can honestly say that we go by this teaching every day at County King Solomon. We have countless of clubs run by student leadership and teachers that make sure that everyone's included and learns something every day. We are given numerous chances to volunteer and help charities such as Jewish Care, which encourages our students to help others and show them kindness when others have not. When I first started Year 7, I was the only person that had transitioned to County King Solomon from my primary school. I was worried I wouldn't make friends easily and I'd be lonely. However, this was not the case, and during my first week I met loads of new people and made loads of new friendships that I still treasure to this day. Here in County King Solomon, the drive to support and help one another is ingrained in us since day one. The teachers are extremely attentive and will always make time for you, regardless of how packed their day is. I hope your children and family grow to treasure this school just as much as I do.
I can confidently and proudly say there is nowhere else I'd rather be, and hope to see all your children's faces as they start the first step of their journey towards their future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And now it's a great pleasure to introduce you to the head of the Year 7, Ms. Sam Liu. I'm sure you've received many of her emails, you've seen her on video calls, and now you get to see her in person, which is fantastic. She'll introduce who her team are and give you those extra bits and pieces of information ahead of the September start. Thank you.
Hello. It was really great to meet your children last week when they came into Transition Day. I hope it gave them a nice little taste of what secondary school is like. Team. Ms. Lawrence will be the assistant head of year, who will be supported by our form tutors underneath. You'll find out your child's form tutor in September, and you'll hear from them then. The form tutor is our first point of contact, so if there are any questions or anything that you're worried about, please email them. If there's any other question that you may have, in your pack, you'll find my email in there. I'm happy to answer any questions. I will get back to you, I promise. Also in that pack, I know there's a lot of information that's coming your way in a very short amount of time. There's a parent pack. In there, there's details about everything that Ms. Mawa has spoken to you about. There is the timetable. There's also some information in the back about uniform. One thing that I want to point out are the term dates. There are quite a few Jewish holidays in September. Make sure you keep a hold of that pack. Use it as a reference. They'll come in a lot of it will come in handy during the first year. So, I get asked a lot, what does a school day look like? We start at 8:30, child to be in form. During that time, we'll check uniform, we will make sure they're set for the day, and we will also do tefillah and thought of the day. It's a really good opportunity for your to make sure, for us to make sure they're ready to go. Then we'll run through our five lessons, there'll be a break and a lunchtime. I want to highlight that there are six different points at this point that your child will go through on a daily basis, form and their five lessons. This is really important because my key message is organization is key. The image of the young man behind me is not dissimilar to what most of your sevens will look like. They will have a big backpack opening everything and their kitchen sink on a regular basis. Keep in mind, whatever they bring, they will have to bring to six different places every single day. My key thing that you can do, we run on that two-week timetable. Have a copy of that timetable out and help your child build a routine. I pack my bag every night before. I don't like being rushed in the morning. I like to make sure it's set and ready to go. I recommend you do that with your child as well. There's no point in them bringing all their books for a two-week timetable when they only need five. There's no point in them bringing their PE kit if they don't have PE that day. It's an extra thing to carry around. If they don't need it, that also includes valuables. It's an extra thing for them to worry about. I go back to bring a PE kit, the number of times your sevens come up to me and go, I don't know where it is, I don't know where I put it. And halfway through the conversation, they'll come and tell me, I didn't even have PE today, I don't know why I brought it. Make sure that whatever they bring is all they need. I always talk about differentiating exercise books. As all those exercise books come in, you'll recognize that there'll be three or four that are green or blue, they're all very similar. A lot of students decorate their cover so they can differentiate the books. Some teachers require that. I say at the very least, make sure you put the name at the very top or a sticker or something to differentiate them. Then it helps them make sure that they don't bring their mask up to their science lesson. It creates a lot less stress. Secondly, and then the school day. Those of you that picked up your child last week, you would have either seen myself or Miss Reese at the gate with the children lined up. You'd pick to see your child, you'd wave, and we let them go. That's not going to happen in secondary school. When that bell goes, they leave. So, especially at the very beginning, make sure you pick a meeting spot. That'll be less stress on them, and I'm sure it'll be less stress on you. If they know when they leave the school gate, they're going to meet in a specific spot. So 3:15, from year 7 all the way up to 6th form, will be dismissed and they'll leave through the gate. Best thing to do. Secondly, make sure you set those boundaries. If you don't want your child to go onto the high street, which is highly accessible, and get a snack at the end of the school day and hang with your mates, make sure you tell them. Because again, when that school bell goes at 3:15, they're making that choice before they hop on that bus to hang out on the high street. Get the hell set up and ready to go. My very last message. Communication is key. Working on one TA will achieve their personal best. It works best as you come back into when you work in, as you join our community, this will work best when you communicate. If you have any questions or anything that you're worried about, please make sure you send us an email. Again, I will always respond. I'm always here to help. Together, I'm sure that we can make sure every single child reaches their personal best. I'm really looking forward to getting to know each and every single child when they start in September. And thank you again for coming this evening.
You may or you may not know, we're a voluntary aid in school. What that means is the government only provide 90% of our capital fund and our capital funding, and we are expected to find the other 10% from voluntary contributions. We really need your support with this. The changes that we can make to the school and to the buildings and to our resources particularly depend on getting that 10% of contributions from yourselves. In your pack, you will find a letter from our Chair of Governors detailing some of the things that we have been able to do with the voluntary contributions. Everything from minibuses to classroom refurbishments, changing to the outside, making the outside safer in terms of things like paving in areas where students need to line up, providing things like the outdoor gym. None of that could have been possible, or would have been possible, without voluntary contributions from parents. There is a suggested amount. To be honest with you, and the governors will probably be cross with me for saying this, really anything that you can give is better than nothing. So if you look at that that suggested amount, and it, you can't do that, we absolutely understand. Please don't worry about that. Just anything that you can afford, especially in these difficult times, would be really appreciated. So a big thank you to that for that. One last thing to say, you will get an email with a link to a form. It won't be a please tell us how you can do it, because they're really quite annoying. What it will be is have you got any questions? And so if you've got any questions, because of the nature of having to have three different presentations in one day,